Hi guys, in this video I explain how to install Entware on router Asus RT-AC56U. First step, we try to install download master. I have the one pen drive formatted with an NTFS file system. Anyway, I suggest to use file system such as ext2 or ext3. We can go. We need only to install the first part of download master. We can cancel now. We can cancel. Okay, now we open the terminal and we go to OPT folder. We remove all the files except .asusrouter because this file is used by the router to mount the OPT folder. Now we go to, we can install Entware. We go to TMP folder and we must know the platform we have, in this case ARM v7, and the kernel number 2.6. We go back to the browser and we open one tab with this address bin.entware.net. We select the proper folder. In this case we have before dash we have the platform, after dash we have a kernel number. So in this case we have ARM v7 and kernel .2.6. We select this folder and we select the folder named installer. The file we have to download is this generic .sh. This is a script file. We copy and paste and we go back to the terminal. We use wget all the address of the script. We download it. So now we have here. We give to this script the permission to be executed. So we use chmod. Okay, we have this. We can execute this script. Okay, we have installed Entware. Two notes. First one is this. We don't need this because the OPT bin and OPT has been are automatically added to path variable using the file .asusrouter, as I told you before. We come back to OPT, and if you note, we have this file .asusrouter. With this file, the router not only mount the OPT folder, but also add this two file, the OPT bin, these two folders, OPT bin and OPT has been, to path variable. The last note is we cannot follow this note, because Entware, in this case, we find another way to create startup scripts. Now I want to know if we have installed Entware. We use OPKG, for example, in this way. OPKG. I want to know how many packages are installed. These are the packages already installed. I want to install, for example, Nano Editor. Okay. If I want to know all the files included in package Nano, I use this. It is better if I use sort. Okay. This is the executable file. So I can use this to execute Nano. Okay. If I want to remove Nano and all the files, all the other packages included in Nano, I have to use this. Okay. Now we use again. Now I explain how to execute some scripts whenever we insert a pendrive or whenever we remove one pendrive. We use two keys inside NVRAM. So, this key is for mount, while this script is for unmount. For example, whenever I insert a pendrive, I want to execute this script in OPT etc autorun sh. We do the same thing for unmount. We call it auto stop sh. We do again this. Okay, we have changed. Now we commit. Don't forget it. NVRAM commit. We put again, OK. Now we go for example, we use OPTC, we create SH. We create this, for example, auto run txt. We do same thing here. Just a moment, I check. So now we test if it works. For example, if I want to remove the pen drive, I can use this command. We just wait. There is no pen drive now. We go to TMP, and if you note, we already have autostop.txt. So the script works. Now we mount again, we insert again the pen drive, and we use this command. Hot plug 2. So now we have another file, autorun.txt with hello. For example, we go to OPT-AETC. Okay, now I explain how to use a swap file. With the free command, I can know that we have not a swap file. Now we create it. We have two scripts. The first one is this, to make the file. This is to disable swap file. Now we execute the first one. This is the folder and swap file, so paths and file. We can execute free command again, and we see that we have swap file. If we want to disable it, we execute this file, this script. Swap file is zero again. If in the future we want to update all the packages included in Entware installation, we simply use these two commands. First one is this opkg update, the other one, to upgrade all the packages, we use this command.